awesome. So y'all have any words to the people out there that want to grow beards, that want to check y'all out? Just a piece of, you know, I don't know, advice, some kind of...
What's kind of neat is...
Last words.
You know, there have been some people who have been, you know, involved on our Facebook group for a while and posted and commented and things like that. And all of a sudden they'll be like, hey, when I comb my beard, like a lot of hair is falling out. Have you guys seen, like, we get actual, like, legitimate growing, like,
questions.
Your beard questions.
Wow.
And it's just like, some of us know these things, others don't. And it's just like, oh yeah, that's totally natural. Don't worry about it. Or, you know, we all kind of learn something and share our own knowledge, because when you're growing a beard for like a purpose and you're actually like trying to grow something to a length or have a goal in mind or a style that you're going for, you know, you try to make that happen. It's not just letting it grow.
Yeah.
And so sometimes people are doing it for the first time. They're like, hey, what do I do? Like, they really don't know.
and it's not just letting it grow, obviously.
Yeah, it's because there's a difference between growing a beard and grooming a beard.
Okay.
And that's a distinction that people don't really immediately know right off the bat. If they're growing their first beard, they're not going to really know the difference between growing and grooming. And that's, you know, kind of where we come in as far as, you know, being a support community, if you will.
Yeah.
And they get different ideas from everybody that's in the club too as well. Because not everybody, somebody's way might not work for somebody else.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But everybody that chimes in, they get different, you know, techniques, so they can, you know, pick and choose which works best for them. So
yeah,
it's not just one set.
Well, thank you, Wes, for letting me touch your beard. Is that allowed, like,
yeah,
in public?
Yeah.
No, I mean, like, in general, do y'all get that a lot? A lot of people want it?
Yes.
I get that a lot,
that's
yeah. And, you know, it's surprising. I actually get it a lot from the guys as well as ladies, too, which is really strange. The guys don't get to touch it so much. They have to sneak up on me in order to do that.
So you allow the ladies, but not the men.
I allow the ladies to an extent, yeah. But, I mean, a lot of people are curious. You know, it's not every day that you come across a person who's sporting a big full beard. So,
yeah.
At this point in San Antonio, it is something that's
especially this time of year,
extravagant and foreign. Yeah. Yeah, especially during the summer.
It's hot under there, isn't it?
Everybody says it's like, why
it's
is it
not
so hot?
Too bad. I'm
see,
I'm
it's,
so
it's
white
my upper
that
lip
it's just
that
less
bothers me.
Places I've got to put on sunscreen.
You're so white.
Also, and you do have to, because I went to the beach. And I thought, because I had the beard, it's fine. Oh, I got this burnt right here, horrible. I had like two rosy red cheeks.
That's what this is for, my friend. That's,
yeah. I'm going to start styling it.
Oh, there you go.
Start styling it upwards,
this is the rest
so it covers my face.
Well, that's gentlemen, Wes gave us a little bit of advice. Andy, you have any last words for our bearded audience, non-bearded audience?
Oh, Wes, no, I would just like to thank y'all for having us. This was a great experience. And anybody who's seeing this, I would just like to invite you to join us, come find out about us, and come help us raise money for San Antonio Charities.
And Danny, I would offer you some last words, but I'm sure no one cares to hear what you have to say.
I'm gonna say it anyway. Those of you that are about to start growing, you're gonna come in contact with other people who might not agree with you growing it. Ignore them. Grow it how you feel. You know, just do it. Do it. You know, and eventually they're gonna grow to. They're gonna come to accept it, and eventually they're gonna like it, and then they're gonna be asking you more about it. So,
and also,
don't be discouraged by your stubble.
And also, there is the perpetual question of, does it ever stop itching? If you grow your beard past 2 or 3 weeks, you will be fine. You'll forget it's there. It will not itch anymore.
So put the razor down.
It becomes another appendage.
Well, there's a lot of folks who grow that where at the beginning, you know, your hair is curled back in.
And it'll irritate
and so,
the skin.
But you know, this oil that we had here, this helps with that. It helps moisturize and things like that.
Oh, snake
venom. Good little house, yeah. Little snake venom.
Never hurt nobody.
Oh my gosh, y'all are a trip.
That weird tonic in there.